Hey, it's Kaylee, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to play some really fun multiply and divide games. Let's play. So here we are in the home screen of the arithmetic game, and the first one we are going to do is a multiply game. So we'll click here. And we're going to choose our level, and how about together, let's work on level two. So what we see here is a big chart, a big multiplication chart here. It gives us a question. So in this case, it's 3 times 9. And then we're going to use the number pad here. We're going to click fill in, click the numbers of what you think the answer is, and then check your answer. For each right answer, you get a point. All right. So first ones first, 3 times 9. Remember when you're using a multiplication chart, you can either count all of these squares here, or you can count by threes in this case down the line, or we can count by nines going this way. So we can count by threes because there's 1, 2, 3. So we go 3, 6, 9, all the way down, or we can go 9, 18, and then all the way down. Okay. So in this case, does anybody know what 3 times 9 is? Do they have it memorized? And if not, we can go 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, 24, 27. So we'll click 27 for 27. Check my answer. Right. Nice job. So now they've given us a new one, 1 times 4. So we can either count all of these squares, we can count by ones, or we can count by four. Remember, when it's 1 times 4, it's always just whatever the bigger number is. So it's 4. Check it. Nice. 1 times 8. Again, when it's 1 times the number, it's always that bigger number. So we go 8. Perfect. 3 times 2. Does anyone know it off the top of their head? Can you count these purple squares? Or we can go 2, 4, 6. Click the 6. Check our work. Woohoo! 1 times 2. This is an easy one. 2 in there. Nice work. 3 times 6. Okay, you might have to think about this one. You might have to count some squares. So let's count 6 squares. 12 squares, 18 squares. So we have 18. Check our work. So 2, 9 times 2. Does anyone know this one? So 9 times 2. So we have a column of 9. We add another column of 9. Or we can go 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. 14, 16, 18. Plug it in and check our work. Nice. 3 times 1. We know it's going to be that bigger number. Click the 3. Check our work. Perfect. 1 times 3. So now it's instead of the squares going down, they're going across, but it's still going to be 3 because it's times 1. 5 times 1, so it's 5 blocks going down. We know it's 5. Check our work. Nice job. Let's do one more all together. So 5 times 8. Do you remember this one? So we can either count by 8s going down, or it might be easier to count by 5s going across. So we have 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. 30, 35, 40. So 40. You see, we counted by fives for each row of, or each column of fives that we have there. And we can check our work. Nice job! So far we've done 11 of them. We've gotten them all right. And let's go back to our home screen. And this time we are going to do the factor. All right, so we'll come in here. So now this one's a little different. They're asking us what times what is equal to 24. So what are the factors of 24? What two numbers equal 24 when you multiply them? So You can either count squares, or we can say, if we are going to do 6, how many columns of 6 do we need before we equal 24? So it's 6, 12, 18, 24. So 6 times 4 are factors of 24. You can click it. And there it is. We're right. So what times what is 5? Well, we could do an easy one. Do 1 all the way over to 5. Click it. Perfect. Another way. What's another way that we can get 5? Well, we can do it the opposite way. So we can start with the 1 column. We go down to the 5 row. Perfect. And 6. Well, we could do 1 over to 6. But what's another way? What are other factors of 6? 2 and 3. Multiplied together is a factor of 6. How about 10? Well, we could go over to the 5 column. And if we go down for 2, we have 10. So 2 and 5 are factors of 10. Now 20. Let's see here. If we do 20, we can go over to the 4. I know 4 is a factor of 20 because they're even multiples of 2. And I can go down for the 5, right? So if I go 4, 8, 12, 16, 20. Perfect. Nice job. So you kind of get the hang of it. You drag the finger across to whatever you think the factors are, and then you give them a click. So for this one, I'm driving across to 2 and 6. Give it a click. Nice. So now you can try these ones on your own as well. We'll go back to the home screen, and we're going to do the last game for the arithmetic video, and it is divide. So I'll click in here. Let's go for our level 1 for now. So now let's see. It's asking us, what is the first number if I give you the second number in the equation and the answer? So another way to think about multiplication is division. So in this case, we'd say what times 6 is equal to 6, or we can say 6 divided by 6 is equal to what? It's going to be 1. We check it. All right. So 4 times what is equal to 4, or we can say 4 divided by 4 is equal to 1. Check our work. Perfect. What times 6 is equal to 24? Or we can say 24 divided by 6 is equal to, so if we have 6 over here, how many rows of 6 are we going to need to get to 24? Can you count? You can either count them across. So it'd be 6 of them there, 12 of them there, 18 of them there. One more row of 6 would give us 24, and that's the 4 row. So we'll click the 4, check our work. Perfect. 3 times what is equal to 12, or we can say 12 divided by 3. So how many times does 3 go into 12? How many times can you fit 3 in 12? 4 times. Check our work. Nice. So now you can just keep going through these and play the game, and you'll keep figuring out how many factors of 2 will go into 2. In this case, we know that's 1. Check it. So nice. So have fun. You can go through all of these games, starting with the multiply, and then the factor, and then the divide. So have fun, and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.